is time.
College ain't ready for this fight. I'm taking the W.
All the way from
my tolerance back. For incompetence has been dwindling. My appetite for excellence is still magnificent. My passion for politics been diminishing. Before you approach me, check your intentions, man. Running up determination and adrenaline. Driving around the opposition, claiming residence. Last call, all aboard, how I'm closing in. On everything I've been imagining, you know I've been problematic. When I approach a beat, man, you should know what's bound to happen. Y'all stay mad and fake online, but I got real life happening. Life's a notion, my story too deep, more than a caption. I'm more concerned about retention than who Twitter canceling. If you don't invest in you, then who gon' be your benefactor? Don't let them own your masters, cause they'll become your master. Then they'll label you a slave from the land of what's free. They tryna make my home a cage. Had to fear God, and I'm in full of Lorenzo, made the show.
Granny said you have the what?
Best grandson.
All right, Jason, tell us what we're doing today, bro.
You're welcome. Label, number 23. Greatest label of all time, you feel me? I got six championships for cotton picking.
We
know, nigga number 37 ain't never done a damn thing in this life. So,
look, you know, 37, that's not my walking number. That's my body count.
Oh.
I ain't talking about section.
Oh, this nigga a killer for real. This nigga, what y'all number mean?
What's my number mean?
Yeah.
I don't even know.
What's y'all number mean?
My number is you.
Oh, okay, that's a bar. Joram, Joram.
This number means like 41, or days I've been thugging.
Oh, 41 days of thugging, all right. I ain't gonna hold you, I don't know what my number means. It's how old people think I am, I guess. I'm really 35 if you think about it. But like, for real, but other than that, we walk in 2 miles on a Sunday. We finna see how this
game goes.
Oh, we chanting? Oh, we chanting already?
I want to hear it real quick. Let's see if we got it the first time. Your daddy was home when you left.
Your brother was home when you left. Your sister was home when you left. Your cat was home when you left. The fish was home when you left. And that's the reason you left. Jason, update, bro. We got a little piece of oatmeal, you feel me?
Oh, I threw mine.
Yeah. To the birds, anyway. So what did we go over? Like, recap. See if y'all was really paying attention for real. He said what?
Recap, the three S's.
You know, what was the three S's?
Like a little O flake. Not even small, simple. All, like, you know, he said,
Sincere.
Start small. Okay.
Simple.
Okay, be simple.
He said, you really, really check out.
Oh,
he already know.
Oh, they jogging. Hold up. Wait, what?
I'm
walking. Jason, they jogging. Why are you running? Why are you running?
Jason, they done left us for real.
Huh?
Nah, we left them.
Oh. I like that thought process for real.
We got the big what we had. Everybody catching up now.
Okay, the first show we know,
that means that because they got up there first, they're going to be the last ones to finish. They're going to be the last ones yelling at us when we get back to our dorm.
Tired. Come on, Jason, bro. My spiritual guidance, for real. So, how big is your faith? Matthew 17:20 is a mustard seed, for real. That man said, you don't need to be taught how to get banked. You already know how to get banked. And you put time, effort, you know, you intentional. I like, this man spitting for real. Spitting for real. But yeah, be intentional. And you be all right. I don't know what I say for real. All I remember is the intentional part. That's about it. Jason's strapped for his backpack broke. He's struggling back there. We fell behind last time. Could we like just chilling, walking? They over here chilling with me. Everybody else is all the way up there. Tight John.
Y'all are whispering sweet nothings in his ear right now. All I hear is, come on now, bro.
Keep going straight. I promise you, you're not gonna hit nothing, bro.
Go straight through.
Listen,
you got welcome to the table now.
Okay.
Let me go up here and then
Listen
to the table.
Stop.
Back around into the table.
Alright, turn to the right.
Big step, five steps.
Oh, dang. You good?
Hey. That man ran right into you.
Go forward a little bit.
Forward, stop.
Y'all take him around and then to the table.
Alright, go straight.
Hit your little Dougie. Jonathan hitting that Dougie for real.
Going straight.
Tell me what it was like being led.
Oh, it was easy because I had a Hispanic dude and there was a black dude. And, you know, they got two different voices, bro. So, like, you know, it was just so easy to, like, distinctly. I'm not trying to be racist, but, like, you know, it's easy. Man.
So far, you on the path to getting canceled. I ain't gonna hold you.
Why would I get canceled? I was just saying, you know, he got an accent. The black dude got my type of accent.
Yeah.
We will know that you won if this side can drag them past the G. Okay, well, actually, hey, can you come down a little bit? Yeah. Okay.
Oh man.
Oh yeah. He's
gonna end.
Yeah. Wow. That's a bet.
If you guys can drag them past your G, and you guys
it's
can
downhill.
Pass them
they got
past
me right into
here. Okay. Y'all ready? Now wait, really quick. A stands for what? Anybody remember?
Assess the situation.
Listen. Without
judgment.
Give support. You got it. What is the other E?
Encourage.
Professional. Mm, okay. What's the other E?
Encourage.
Boom. You got it. Strength still needs.
Support.
All right. On the mark, get set, go. Okay, ready?
Let's just say, what is the other E?
Get set. That was ready. Go.
Oh.
At the age of 20, at the age of 15, what are we doing to pour into our health? And then when y'all get to my age and you start having family and kids and wives and husbands, your family, your kids, they matter. And what you do with your life is an impact on what's gonna happen. How can you serve God and be your best if you ain't healthy? If you don't feel good, you ain't gonna think good. You ain't gonna operate good, right? So what you do every single day matters. For me, I'm tired of seeing people get sick my age. They really ain't gotta be sick. Does anybody know if your arteries are clogging up? Do you know when you get blood work, what number you should look at? What is it called on your health report, on your physical, the number you should look at to determine if my arteries are starting to clog? Do y'all know? Wrong. Do y'all know? After you get a physical and you're looking at your lab reports, and if you're not looking at your lab reports, shame on you. I know people that go get physicals. I know somebody that got a physical last year and died 2 months later. They had no idea what was going on with their report. I asked the family member, let me see their blood report. I said, that's why they died right there. They had no idea what they were looking at. It could have been prevented. 25 years old, gone. What on your blood, on your labs, on your blood report, you need to know? What is it?
Cholesterol.
What is it called? Close. What is the number one thing you should know? That's diabetes. See, guys, we got to know that. LDL, listen to me. Listen carefully. It might save your life. I'm dead serious. It might save your life. Your LDL, that's your bad cholesterol. We don't know what's going inside. We don't know what's happening with our arteries unless we know those numbers. Your LDL should never be over 100. If it's over 100, you need to be concerned. What that tells me, what raises LDL? Fatty foods. Too much dairy. Not exercising. LDL, your blood vessels are like this. Mm-hmm. And what happens is when you clog it with junk and lack of exercise and nutrition, what happens? Your arteries begin to close up.
It gets tighter.
The LDL is what tells us what's going on with our arteries. If you don't know the number, you can't fix it. Mercy. Mm. So you're only 150 pounds, but your LDL is 175. You're about to have a stroke. Mercy. And don't even know it. Mercy. You don't even know it. Well, my blood pressure's straight, it doesn't matter. LDL, bad cholesterol, reducing those things. It's important, as you talked about. Diabetes, the number to know what diabetes are. Important to know. And if you don't know, start doing research. Because we can be proactive and take care of ourselves. What if things happen, we deal with that. But what are we doing consciously every single day? What we're going to show you right now is that it's real simple, y'all. You don't have to go run marathons and Ironmans. You ain't got to do that. But exercise is a lifestyle. What you put in your body is what you go with, what's going to come out. We eat to die. We don't eat to live. I'm 41 years old. Whatever y'all want to do, you want to hoop? You want to run? You want to play football? Let's get it. Let's get it. I'm like that. I'm like that. Y'all better ask somebody. Mm. Whatever you want to do, let's do it.
He's him.
Because I want to live. I got a wife and I got two kids who are dependent on me. Mm. I have to set the example. And it starts with something simple. I promise you this. If you start off with something simple, give me those sit-ups. Something simple, everything will add. Do those sit-ups. Where's my guy doing sit-ups? Come on. Do them sit-ups. Come on. Something simple, dog.
Yeah. Look at that crew.
Hey, I need my planks. Where's my planks? Drop down and give me my planks. Who's my guy on the plank? Boom. That's a plank. Where's my burpee? Where's my burpees? Every day. 15, 30 minutes of this. 15, 30 minutes of this. Where's my heel repeats?
They don't know you.
Where's my heel repeats? Look, we ain't even got no weights.
Okay, then.
We ain't got no weights.
Okay, then, huh?
Where's my step up? Watch this here.
Come on, Mark.
Come on,
Mark. Look at that. Look at that. We ain't got no weights.
They still going?
Go.
Oh, I feel bad for that plank, dude. I feel bad for planks.
Listen, y'all. Listen. I want you to commit. I want you to commit to 10 to 15 minutes every single day doing something like this. All the extra stuff that I do, triathlons, ride bike, run, all that stuff, that'll come later. Because this is not going to satisfy you forever. You're going to want to add more. Keep going. But if you can do something like this, 15 minutes, be conscious of what you're eating. We just learned that. Know your numbers. Look what he's doing. That boy in shape.
Yeah, man.
Come on, man. Come on. Watch how fast this man can run. Get me all the way to that building and come back.
Yeah! That's a real black man.
Hey, that's
an
Owani. That boy's going.
Off with speed, but it kept coming back.
Hey, you do that and make sure you're getting this in. Make sure you're getting your water. I promise you, I need y'all to commit when I see you on campus. I need to commit for the rest of the school year, 10, 15 minutes. I didn't ask for no weights. You did it right here. Look at him. He didn't go to no gym. Look at him. He was working. They all was working. It don't take a lot, team. Let the reminder of your family, your health, your loved ones that are no longer alive, all those things be a reminder to you to be consistent so God can fully use you, because if you don't feel good, you can't be used. I mean, you can. You can be used. But if you don't feel good, you can't be the best version of yourself. Let's go hands in on three. Hey, let's break on being great, y'all. Hands on being great. I need everybody to commit for the rest of the year. Give me 10 to 15 minutes. That's all I need. 10 to 15 minutes of exercise every day. On three, we're breaking on being great. Ready? One, two, three.
Be great.
Be great.
Be great.
All right, where we headed now?
said that I could come back home.
My daddy took
He bought everything.
I put in this car.
Before I left.
To my daddy's head.
He said that I will become a man.
Almost done.
In the race of life.
We gotta get there first.
And right on time.
How you feel?
America.
Y'all came and y'all stayed to the end. So that's a great job. Hope you learned something. I hope you got some experience. I hope you start introducing and talking to different people. This is a community. Edwards, Holland, we had some guys from West Oaks. So this is a community of men. We're men on campus and we need to start acting like the men on campus.
Amen.
I don't need to see no more of this. There's females out here, but I don't need to see no more of that. I don't need to see no more of that stuff from y'all. So what I'm just saying is, man, like, let's get it. And to end this day off, it wouldn't be the same if I would just sit there and run and we talk, we have fun. But I decided to ask some of my brothers, my pastors to come. We got a creed. Everybody's got this creed in your hand. Yeah. You can throw it away if you want to. It ain't gonna do me no harm. But if you want to put this up in your room,
Amen.
Put it on your window, put it beside your bed, whatever the case may be, maybe this is something that'll just motivate you to continue to be the Oakwood man, the men of God that we're supposed to be,
Amen.
Right? I'm not asking you to be perfect. I ain't perfect. Trust I'm far from perfect. But God told me to lead, and no, that's what I'm gonna do.
Amen.
So I started listening to what my daddy had to say,
Come on now.
And I need y'all to start listening to what daddy say to y'all, because he tell y'all the truth, even though we don't wanna hear it sometimes. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna ask Pastor Lee from Madison Mission to come up. He's gonna read everything in yellow. We're gonna start reading the scripture together. When it gets down, First Church. Pastor Lee, the one that played basketball on the pulpit. He's gonna read everything in yellow. We're gonna read the scripture together. He's gonna read everything in yellow. Then we will all say what's in white. When we get down here to the very bottom, that everything is in cap, all bold, we're all gonna read it together. Do we understand?
Yes, sir.
Do we understand?
Yes, sir.
That's what I'm talking about. We men.
All right, let's go. Be on your guard.
Stand firm in faith. Be a man of courage. Be strong. Do everything in love.
1 Corinthians 16:13-14.
Be on your guard.
Be ready. Stay alert. Expect God to be involved. Expect Satan to attack.
Be a man of courage.
Fear is not from God. So move boldly. The worst that can happen, even in death, still ends in victory and glory for the Christian man.
Be strong,
physically, mentally, spiritually, meaningfully, to resist the Holy. Remembering that the Lord is my strength
my weakness. He is my strength. I am strong, honorable, a leader, a gentleman, bold yet humble, patient and intelligent. I am one who walks tenderly before the Lord God. I am man. With God as my leader, Jesus as my example, and the Holy Spirit as my comforter, I will master manhood. Amen. Next thing that I want to do is I'm going to bring Pastor Lee from Madison up. He's going to pray over all of us as men of Oakwood, the ones that are here, the ones that were here, and the ones that just decided not to come. But as he does that, my pastors are around. So I got some pastors and elders. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to act, well, we got oil. But if you wanted to come and get anointed as we pray, after we pray, just move up. And we just want to anoint your hands with oil.
Yeah.
Just so that you can seal this. I know we sweaty. I know that this is like yucky, but I just, this is something that's encouraging. This is something that you can remember. And even as you wipe the oil away as you take a shower, just remember that you've been touched by God.
Yeah.
And we are to be God's man. And we are going to conquer manhood.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, Lord, we're grateful, Lord, that you gave us life. And thankful, Father, for this opportunity to learn even more how to be the men that you called us to be. Praying over these young men, God, that you would give them every gift that's available to Father at their disposal, God, to help them to become all that you have called them to be. We pray, Lord, that angels who excel in strength and might watch over their every way. We pray, Lord, that they will have discernment, dear Father, so that the enemy, when he tries to snatch away the things that you're trying to put in them, God, that they would notice those things, Lord, and then act accordingly. We pray, dear Father, over every decision that they have to make. We pray over every female that they interact with. We pray, Lord, for the relationships that they have with each other. We pray, dear Father, that all of the bad energy, God, the bad experiences, dear Father, that you will work those things out for their good, and that you will use those things, Lord, to develop them into the men that they need to be. We pray, Lord, that their sins be forgiven. We pray, dear Father, that everything that you have for them, Father, may they receive. And at the end of the day, God, we ask you, dear Father, to bless them and save these young men.
Yes.
Help them to realize, dear God, that they're in a cocoon, which means they're just being prepared to break out and be all that you have called them to be.
Mm-hmm.
Help them to realize that they are now more than conquerors, Lord, because you've called them.
Yes.
And help them, Father, to know, God, that without a shadow of doubt, that you love them right where they are, even now, dear Father. Keep them from discouragement. Help them in their studies. And we pray, dear Father, most and foremost, God, that at the end of the day, when you come in your clouds of glory, God, that every single man here, those who were here, their friends, their loved ones, their family, God, will be saved in your kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you for Elder Mann. We thank you, Lord, for this ministry. Thank you, Lord, for the men on this campus. We pray, Lord, that you will surround them, Father, with love and with presence, God, and help these young men to be all that they have called to be. And at the end of the day, God, we also ask that their time here may be well spent.
Mm-hmm.
Keep them, Father. And then in that present day, God, they're going to graduate from here and go out and depart as men, servants of the living God.
Yeah.
Help them to be all they're called to be, God. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
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 All right, just take this sign and just come up. We'll talk to the pastors and get anointed. And then my RAs, step out to the back, and then we'll start giving worship credits for everybody that ended the race.
You get
worship credits. And we will change them not from one, but we will change them to three.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
Just because you finished.
Amen.
That's a bet.
Wow.
In the West Street, they trying to make my home a cage.
Problematic.